Greetings, dear candidates, and welcome to our science lesson for today. My name is Johnny Korat, going to take you through this lesson. To begin with, I want us to go to what we looked at in the previous lesson. It was about wages. And what did we say a wage is? Okay? Yes. We actually said that a wage is a cutting tool. And we also say that a wedge is a double inclined plane. Do you remember that? Yes. Okay, can we mention some examples of wedges that we talked about? Anyone to tell us one example of a wedge that we discussed in that previous lesson? Yes, we talked of knives, we talked of axes, we talked of razor blades. Yes, we also talked of wooden wedges. This one's used for splitting. Yes, remember, wedges can also be used for cutting. They can be used for piercing and other purposes. Do you remember that? Okay. Now, dear candidates, in that lesson, we talked about the uses of wedges. And we say that some wedges, like knives, can be used for cutting. Which cutting are we talking about here? Peeling, matoke, peeling sweet potatoes, peeling cassava, and others. Okay? We also said some wedges like axes can be used for splitting wood. Yes, you can use an axe to split wood. You can use it for cutting wood like that, okay? Some wedges like needles can be used for sewing clothes. All those are uses of wedges. Do you remember all that? Some wedges like razor blades can be used for cutting hair. Do you remember that? I remember when I was still in primary, there is a time our teachers would cut our hair using a razor blade. They just cut your head and they put a sign of a cross here on the head using a razor blade. So a razor blade is a wedge. Now, today, we shall not talk about wedges again, but we shall talk about something that we call screws. Yes. Have you ever seen a screw anywhere? Have you ever used it at home? Have you ever seen any tool at home that contains a screw? And if so, what do we mean by a screw at this moment, dear candidates? Okay. So, dear candidates, a screw is an inclined plane wound around a rod. A screw is an inclined plane wound around a rod. What do we mean there? This is what a screw looks like exactly. When we look at it, it contains an inclined plane that is wound around a rod. There is a rod here, which is stiff, okay? But around it, there is an inclined plane that is wound around it. That inclined plane wound around a rod is called a screw. Are we together, dear candidates? Now, when we look at inclined planes that we talked about in that lesson, we talked about a certain inclined plane that we call a winding what? Rod. So when we look at a screw, it is almost like a winding rod because you see, it winds around. It winds around as a rod. That's why we call it an inclined plane. So what is a screw? Can we read that together? A screw is an inclined plane wound around a rod. Now, this is an illustration of a screw. A screw has got some parts. And what are those parts? There is this part that we call the head. That's where you place the screwdriver. There is a provision where you place the screwdriver around the head of a screw. Then, a screw has got this inclined plane winding around a rod. That inclined plane winding around a rod is what we call the threads. Those are threads. Those things that are winding around that rod are the ones that we call threads. Okay? So these are threads. Then, now, there is a distance between two successive threads. The distance between two successive threads is called the thread pitch. Or you can just call it the pitch. Pitch of a screw. That is the pitch of a thread. We call it that. So, I hope you have got to understand that the threads, then the distance between two successive threads is the thread pitch. Then there is the head. Those are some of the parts of a screw. Now, dear candidates, I want us to look at the examples of screws. Wow. Oh, examples of objects with the screws. Can we identify some of them? Can you tell me one object at home that uses a screw or that has a screw? What are some of them? We have got one example that we call a car jack. A car jack is a device that is used for raising a car or lifting it up during repairing. So when the mechanic is repairing, he uses the car jack to lift the car a bit higher so that he can easily deal with what is at the bottom of that car. That's the car jack. We also have bolts and nuts. We shall later on see the pictures or the diagrams of that. We have bolts and nuts. We also have drilling machines. Wow, that one is a machine used for drilling holes in objects. For example, drilling a hole through a wall, we can use a drilling machine. If you want to drill a hole through the wood, you can use a drilling machine, okay? Then we also have some bottle lids. When you look at the lids of soda bottles, they contain the threads. That means they are screws, okay? Some bottle lids, even lids of jerrycans contain those. Some jerrycan lids also contain screws. We also have screw nails. Yes, screw nails are basically found in radios, okay? They can be found in some machines. Yes, we have screw nails. And then we also have the engineer's vise. Engineer's vise is that device that is used for holding metals when they are cutting. That is the engineer's vise. And then lastly, we have the micrometer screw gauge. Micrometer, that one is basically used for measuring the diameter of very tiny objects. Measuring the diameter of very tiny objects. That is a micrometer screw gauge. So I want you to take note of those examples of screws. Now, we have some questions. What is a screw? You remember that. And then give any two examples of screws. We have all of these as examples of screws. Now, after looking at the examples of screws, we want to go and look at the uses of screws. Why do you think screws are of great importance in our daily life? How do we benefit from having screws? What do we use these screws for? One, screws hold the parts of machines together. I want you to look at a machine like a radio. I want you to look at a machine like a car. Look at a machine like a woofer. It has got screws. Screws are used for holding parts of machines together. Look at the parts of a computer, a laptop, for example, that you are having, parts of a camera. There are screws that are used for holding those parts together. So we say screws hold parts of machines together. Without screws, then those parts of machines would get dismantled. Okay? And some of them would even get lost. Number two, we are saying screws are used for drilling holes in objects. Wow! Which screw do you think is used for drilling holes in objects? For example, drilling a hole through a wall, drilling a hole in wood. Which screw do we use? Somebody remembers that? Yes, we use a drilling machine. Number three, we are saying that screws are used to tighten lids of tins, bottles, and jerrycans. Now, let us look at a jerrycan, for example. If you want to tighten it, it's used in a lid of a jerrycan to tighten that jerrycan so that the water you have in the jerrycan does not pour out. Okay? Look at a soda bottle. It contains that lid which has a screw in it. So, for you to tighten that soda bottle so that the soda does not pour out, you need a screw. So, we say screws are used to tighten lids of tins, bottles, and jerrycans. Okay? Then, screws are also used for lifting very heavy materials. For example, lifting a car upwards. For a car to be lifted, which machine do we use? We use a car jack or what we call a screw jack. Place it at the bottom of the car and then turn the screw. There is the handle there. Turn the screw and then you will be able to lift that car upward. Screws are used for lifting very heavy materials. Screws are used to measure the diameter of very small wires. There is a screw, an object which contains a screw that we call a micrometer screw gauge. Now, a micrometer screw gauge is used for measuring the diameter of very tiny wires. You have a very tiny wire, you want to know how, actually you want to know its diameter, you can use a micrometer screw gauge. That micrometer screw gauge can also be used if you want to measure the diameter of your hair. You can use a micrometer screw gauge. So we say screws are used to measure the diameter of very small wires. But remember, which screw is that? Micrometer screw gauge. And then screws are also used for opening some bottle tops like wine bottles. There is a wine bottle opener. It contains a screw in it. So for you to open the bottle of wine, you need a wine bottle opener. Screws are used for that purpose. Now, which questions are there? State any two uses of screws. All of these, dear candidates, are the uses of screws. Okay? Take note of some of them: holding parts of machines together, drilling holes in objects, being used to tighten lids of tins. Screws are used for lifting very heavy materials. Screws are used to measure the diameter of very small wires. And also, screws are used for opening some bottle tops, like wine bottles. I want you to remember that, okay? Now, let us go ahead. Let us look at the diagrams of some objects with screws. Diagrams of some objects with screws. What is the first one there? We have bolts and nuts. That is, have you ever seen that somewhere? Yes, that is. This is what we call bolts and nuts. Now, this one and this are bolts. This one and this are bolts. The ones I'm pointing, look at that arrow. This one and this are bolts. Whereas these two, this one and this are nuts. They work together. You first fix a bolt through a hole, then you tie using a nut. Okay? So bolts and nuts are screws. Then we also have drilling machine. This is what a drilling machine looks like. It is a screw itself. Now, you press here, and then this part will rotate. That screw will rotate. Now, when it rotates, it is able to drill the hole, either through the wood or through the wall of the building. Okay? That is a drilling machine. Then we also have a car jack. This is what we call a car jack. A car jack is used for lifting, for example, a car. You want to repair your car, you want to lift it up so that you can go maybe at its bottom to repair what is there, you use a car jack. A car jack is also called a screw jack, okay? Screw jack. Now, it contains this part that you just turn in order to tighten. As you turn that, this other part moves upwards, and therefore enabling you to lift that car upwards. So that is a car jack. Then we also have another example of object with the screws that we call screw nails. These ones are common. Look at that. These are the ones that are used, for example, to fasten parts of a radio together, fasten parts of a watch together, parts of a clock together. We use screw nails. So these ones here are called screw nails. Then we also have other screws, okay? We have that object that we call the engineer's vise. Engineer's vise looks exactly like this. It has got this part that we call the handle, and then we have this part that we call the screw. Now, you turn the handle in order to fasten this point here. This is the point where the object being cut is placed. So if you are cutting, for example, a metal, you place it in between here, and then you fasten this screw to hold it tightly. so that you are able to cut without it shaking. Are we together? Without it making any kind of movement. So that is what we call the engineer's vice. And then we also have another example of an object with a screw that we call a micrometer screw gauge. What is the use of that micrometer screw gauge? We said that can be used for measuring the diameter of very tiny wires. Okay? Now, that is exactly what it looks like. It has got this part. This is where you place the wire whose diameter you want to measure, and then you fasten from this side. So inside there is a screw. Okay? So a micrometer screw gauge looks exactly like that. Now, what is our next issue here? We have an activity. After looking at screws in details, we have learned their uses. Then we go to the activity. What does our activity say? Just read that. Which simple machine is formed by winding an inclined plane around a rod? Give two examples of tools in the above group. That's number two. Three says, state two uses of the tools mentioned in question two. Okay? That means you give the uses of these tools you have named in number two. And then, why are some nails regarded as screws? And do we have any other question? Okay. So we can actually end there with that activity. Now, dear candidates, I want to thank you for learning science with me today. And I remain Teacher Johnny Korat, wishing you a nice day and a successful learning. Thank you for learning.